As silly as it may get, I'm just going to show you how to repair a broken crown like this. Just try and zoom in a little bit more. It's too much. Too much. There we go. Okay, without having to replace the entire panel, because the entire panel, this is an old Sony Vaio, and you can't buy the pan rest. So there's an easy and a quick way of fixing. So let's crack on with this. First of all, is I'd apply a bit of a glue, something very good, not the shitty glue what you can buy from Poundland. You know, use something very strong. So I'm going to sort of apply a bit layer of glue around this. Then I'm going to sit the crown, and I'm going to pick out these bits and then put them on. And then I'm going to apply my second step of repair, basically. So let's just sort of apply a little bit of a glue around this, just so that I can sit the crown and attach those panels. Okay, so that's done. And the reason why I'm sort of showing you this is because buying these panels, even if they're available, because they're rare and hard to find, the cost of the panels can be ridiculously expensive at time to time. So for that reason, I would always sort of recommend sort of repairing them. Now I need to sort of lower my position and pick out the pieces. It doesn't matter if you can't find the pieces, don't worry about it. You can still apply the heat shrink and a bit of glue. But since I've got the pieces, I'm going to sort of put them back. Let me get me another pair of tweezers so I can hold this crown in place. I don't want to put my hands on the way, otherwise you're going to struggle to sort of see what I'm doing. Okay, and then let's try and put the other piece. Assuming that this is going to be... Yep, it is. Yes, it is. It is the piece that belongs in the middle. That would be the final piece that goes on the edge. We are missing one piece, unfortunately, but that's not to worry. Let's apply a bit more glue. In fact, I'm not missing the other piece. The other piece is here. I've just noticed that. It's quite easy, quite common, these sort of things, and it's very handy to know how you can go about repairing it. I've been doing this for a little while, this technique of mine, and it worked absolutely flawless. So when the laptop have come back for a different issue, these crowns that I've fixed, I've never broken off. Try not to get super glue in your hands. Always wear protective. So I don't know if you can see, but let's see where we're at. Okay, oh, I'm gone. Okay, there we go. Okay, so that's where we are with it. I've built the thing back up. Going to give it a nice press just to make sure that it's got a nice snug fit. Now what do I do? Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get heat shrink. This is what I'm going to get. I've got various sizes. Let's zoom out. So I've got various sizes of heat shrink here. Okay, and I'm going to sort of pick out the best one out of the lot, and just to make sure that it sort of it goes over, so it covers from the bottom all the way up to the top. So in that case, I believe that this red one might be the perfect size. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure the height of this. Okay, so it's roughly about there. I'm going to chop it up. Just leave a little bit of an overhang on the top so it holds these little broken pieces in like a, you know, it just conceals it basically, you know, it holds it. You'll see what I mean once I've sort of applied and sorted the shrink. Now, the next step is to apply lots of glue around the outer edge of this. So let me zoom in again and show you what's going to happen. Okay, is that the closest I can get without... Yes, looks like it. Okay, so I'm going to apply a drop, oh, plenty of glue around under here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to slowly put that in, okay? Now you're getting, now you're understanding where this is going now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to apply, because there was a stud there, I want to sort of make this as tight as possible, this side of it, this side, because I'll lift this back up again and show you what I mean. So see where this stud, put this in hand, see this little stud here, there's going to be a gap there and gap there, which means that it's not going to be a very tight, snug fit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply this glue, I can't remember what it's called. It's more used for like wood and things like that, I believe. It's Bostik glue of some sort. I can't remember the exact name. I use it with a hot handy glue gun. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to first put this back on here. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply this and it's already shrunk, which is not good, but it's okay, not to panic. And most probably just take the excess glue and just throw it away. Now what you want to do is scrape off the excess away above from the face of the crown, because obviously the screw's got to go in, and clear the pathway of the crown itself. Okay, always clean your tools after use, especially when you're dealing with super glue. Right, okay, and the last bit is to use a hot air station and just let the heat shrink become tight. And it's already gone, but let's just sort of do the rest. Okay, move away. Now what you want to do is let it cool down. You can put this piece back on. I can't see that being a problem, which I will do very shortly. Give it a couple of hours for it to dry, and then once the super glue has dried, let me zoom out. Once the super glue has dried, this will become solid again. Absolutely solid again. For the chances for that to break again is very minimal, but unless it's been dropped stupidly or it's been abused, you know, then it might break, but on a normal use, very unlikely that you're going to break that off basically. So that's that basically. Let's just put this back in again. If for any reason that you find that this won't go in, like in this instance it won't because of how this is all sort of become a little bit hard because I've used this glue, Bostik glue, What you want to do is get the hot air station, apply a bit of heat for about 10 seconds, soften the heat shrink and the Bostik glue what I've used. Sorry. Drop that camcorder. Okay, now what you want to do is very quickly, before it gets cold, you want to sort of snug that in into its position. Look at that. And just keep pressing onto it up until to a point where it's nice and fit tightly. And in my case, I'm going to put the screws back on just so that before it, just so that when it dries, it's sat nicely. Okay, there we go, and one more screw. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. The only thing I need to cross-reference and make sure that, which I may have to take this off, is that I believe that there's a little stud here that this thing should have gone in, and I'm wondering whether the heat may have expanded it. I doubt it very much that's the case. No, it hasn't. It's just that it's just snug fit into that, so I'm gonna have to clip it in. Just take this out for a minute. And what about this little thing here? This little stud has to go through this hole. Not absolutely necessary, but it would be nice to sort of have it all. I'm going to get a screwdriver and press it in. Check something out. Ah. Oh, right, okay. I know what's going on here. Yeah, you've got to be careful when you're applying the heat as well. Just be careful, because it can create a bit of an expansion or a bit of a movement on the plastic, because obviously heat will. Deform the plastic, so just be careful. And I'm struggling now to try and pray this out, which should have been a pretty straightforward thing. I could leave it as it is, it's no big deal, but the main problem has been resolved. But me being a perfectionist freak, I'm going to try and what I'm thinking is, right, okay, I know what's actually happened. The glue has actually cured or settled. For that reason, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a different method of putting this corner back into its shape. So I'm going to heat this corner up again. Put it through the bottom as well. See what I'm doing. Not too much, because the plastic will start deforming, so be very careful when you're doing something like this. Off. My workshop is just, or the bench, just absolutely ludicrously. Right, what you want to do now is just hold it. It's going to be hot. I should be wearing a pair of gloves, but as if that's going to happen, and just hold it in place for about once it's sort of and that is just about in parallel with the one on this side as well, so I'm quite happy, and that's done. But I'm still not happy with the way. That's quite interesting. Yeah, okay, we're going to leave it to this, actually, as the main factor was that we've literally sort of sorted the issue with the crown. So we're just going to sort of rest the matter here now. Because trying to make something absolutely perfect can turn out to be, you know, an absolute nightmare. And by me pulling this piece out, I may sort of rip out the stud from the base. And if that's the case, then you might have be a bit more difficulty to try and sort it out, but it's sorted now, so I'm not really bothered about this little thing. It's nice and flush. I don't have to be a perfectionist free to sort of sort this out. So yeah, that's all. That's how it's done, basically. Sorry if this should have been a couple of minutes video, but obviously you do encounter with issues. But that's all, really. Hope you learned something. Thank you. Bye for now.